Hi, I'm Chris Edwards with Tennis Warehouse String Review. This is Luxilon Big Banger Original. A popular string on the Pro Tour, Luxilon Big Banger Original revolutionized the game, offering unparalleled spin and control. It was a perfect match for today's powerful rackets and powerful playing style. Today I'm here with Andy Gerst, and Andy, we've been hitting this string for about a month, putting it in various different rackets. Why don't you tell me your opinion on power?
Yeah, I found this string to be extremely low powered, actually, which might sound like a bad thing at first, but it's actually great if you're looking for a lot of control and that kind of muted feel. I know you like that type of string. For me, I typically like a little bit more jump out of my string bed, but I found this string to be very control oriented, which meant kind of low power. How about you, Chris?
Yeah, definitely. It's a firmer playing poly. It's, you know, it's one of those kind of original. The polys early on were pretty stiff, and this one still has plenty of that feel. So it's a low-powered string, but if you know you're a player that likes to stay on the gas, you know, and I really liked it, especially on like an approach shot, because I felt like I could hit through the ball, and the low power allowed me to really be aggressive in that situation. I didn't have to worry about hitting it long, and I also, you know, really mattered what kind of racket I put it in. I know you share that sentiment, so go ahead.
I actually, when I strung it up in my Yonex RDIS 100 mid, which is more control-oriented racket, smaller head size, I actually really liked it. In order to get the comfort I wanted though, because it is a very stiff, low-powered string, I strung it way down in the mid-40s in the tension. Normally I'm in the low 50s for a polyester string, maybe around 50. This one I dropped way down low into the mid-40s. So what did you do with your tension? I know you got it here in your C10 Pro.
Yeah, you know, and I hit it in the extreme because we were both on that playtest too. And although I wasn't, you know, really grooving on the feel because it was a little brassy and a stiff feeling racket like that, I did like the control level it brought to that racket. So it was good control and spin for me in the extreme. But in the C10 Pro, I really love it. And the low powered response is perfect for this racket. I was able to drop down from about my usual like 55, 57 pounds in this racket into the low 50s. This one today I have it 50. And I'm still getting enough control on the ball to you know, do what I want and not overhit. So it's a great match for this racket.
Now I found another attribute about this string that I really liked was the spin potential. Because it's a low powered string, once again, you have to really have that high swing speed in order to generate the pace that you want while it still maintains its control. So when you take those big swings, big cuts at the ball, you're able to generate a lot of spin. I got a lot of top spin off the ground. I was able to really let loose on my serve, get some good slice, good kick serves. And then on the volleys, I was getting nice control, really knifing the ball up at the net. What did you think, Chris?
Yeah, I have to agree. You know, it's not one of those strings I hit. Like some of the softer, newer polys that are maybe shaped as well, I feel like they bite when you hit the ball and you feel the ball in the strings. There are other strings out there I feel like bite the ball better, but the end result is my ball is coming off the racket with a lot of spin. And I think, you know, it's just that kind of that firmer feel. It really reminded me of Kirschbaum competition. Almost like the ball is sliding across the string bed, but it, you know, racket spits it out with plenty of spin. And again, it just lets you stay aggressive, you know, from so many different situations on the court. And I liked it. Serves, I felt like I was getting some good kicks and good slice on the ball. So yeah, it's very, very spin friendly. As far as durability and tension and maintenance, you know, how did you find that?
I couldn't break this string, Chris. This string's been in here for almost a month now. I played with it pretty excessively the first few weeks that I had it in here. The tension maintenance was great. It really took almost maybe over 2 weeks to drop in tension. And obviously, you know, it's stayed durable and it hasn't broken.
So as you heard, both Andy and I really enjoyed this playtest of Luxilon Big Bang Original. That's all we got for this one. Be sure to check us next time. Thanks for watching.